How about right now? Oh, that bass. So I'm going to start again. Hello, everyone. All right, that's right. When you come to my graduation for my babies, it is excitement. I want to welcome all of our graduates, our students, our families, our school district and community-based partners, and our college community supporters. I am so excited to be welcoming all of you to our fourth Gateway to College graduation. Now, isn't this a most beautiful day? That means clap, y'all. Before we get into our program, I want to extend a heartfelt appreciation to all of the people who help us make this day a success. From facilities for reserving and setting up a lovely graduation space, to IT for assisting us with all of the technology needs, to audiovisual for helping us capture the moment, to Culinar for the delicious food that we're going to chow down on, but most especially to all of you for working so hard to give us a reason to celebrate you. I want to also offer my appreciation for the support of the Montgomery County Community College leadership. Under President Stout, our direct support from Vice President and the many other vice presidents, deans, administrators, directors, faculty, and staff who work with us every single day to lend support to the program. You all have been instrumental in ensuring that we have launched a truly successful Gateway to College model. Finally, I want to extend my deepest gratitude for my staff and foundation faculty. These men and women dedicate their time, talent, and energy to ensuring that our students and this program remain a success at the college. Without them, I would be unable to make this all work. Thank you, team. Without further ado, I'm pleased to welcome Dr. Catherine Swanson, Vice President of Student Affairs and Enrollment Management for Montgomery County Community College, and one of our key supporters, to share a few words with all of you. Dr. Swanson.
Thank you, Kimma. Welcome to all of you. It's my pleasure to represent Dr. Karen Stout, our president, our board of trustees, and the administrators, faculty, and staff of Montgomery County Community College, and to welcome all of you here today. And most especially to say congratulations to our graduates and to our award winners who we will be celebrating today. This is an important milestone for all of you in the program. It's an important milestone for the students who are graduating and preparing for their next steps. It's a milestone for our foundation students who will be moving on to their transition semester next fall, and to all of those who will be earning academic accolades and honors today. For many of you, it might be a first time for that experience, and it's because of the safety net that our staff provide that allows you to be able to do that. It's a milestone for your families who are here to celebrate with you. And please know that it's because of your support for your sons and daughters and family members that they're able to achieve success. I'd like to introduce and offer appreciation to the Gateway to College faculty and staff. None of us can be successful without a safety net underneath us, and they are that safety net for this group of students. The unwavering commitment and consistent student support from the Gateway to College faculty and staff has ensured us that we are able to celebrate our transitioning students and our graduating students today. I want to personally thank each of you for your commitment, for your efforts to successfully launch this program. And now we can't talk about it as a new program anymore. We've just completed our second year. This is a program moving into maturity. Under the leadership of Kemma Sharif, the resource specialists Esau Collins and Lori Davidson, our administrative assistant Jezri Waiterman, our student intern Shashan Skelman, and the foundation term faculty, Susan Buchler, Diane McDonald, Vicki Vetro, Karen Harding Tasca, Tracy Halsey, Thomas Smith, and Carrie Ann DiTommaso. The Gateway to College program is fully staffed with dedicated, experienced, talented, and compassionate professionals and educators. You are what makes this program different, and I think, and I apologize to our Camden friends here, I think the best program in the country. You can have the honors of being second. I want to thank our Camden County College colleagues from their Gateway to College program who've joined us today to help celebrate your successes. The Gateway to College National Network is indeed a network of professionals across the country who are doing similar work to support students in meeting their educational goals. I want to share my deep appreciation to our school district partners. If it wasn't for the school districts who are participating in this program, we wouldn't have one. And so I want to offer special appreciation and acknowledge your commitment to support our efforts at building such a successful program. Many of our superintendents, our other district leaders, have served as ambassadors for the program and encouraged other districts to join the partnership. We applaud your efforts and we are encouraged by your continued support. Please stand so that we can all applaud your work in supporting this program. Now to the Gateway to College students, the reason we're here. I work very closely with Kemma to make sure that you all have what you need to be a success, and you have proven that if you use the resources that the college has to offer, stay committed and focused to your goals, you will achieve them. With 21 of you graduating from Gateway to College this semester, you represent our largest graduation to date. I was confident at the launch of the program in fall 2013 that you would be successful, and I am honored to be here 2 years later, graduating many of you who have been with the program for 3 semesters and launching others into your transition semester. Congratulations. Keep working towards the goal of high school graduation, certification, and an associate's or bachelor's degree. I expect to see most of you graduates, hopefully, back on campus in the fall as you continue working towards your associate's degree, since you already have a great first step towards that, and look forward to, in a year or two, seeing you cross the stage under the big tent that you see up behind College Hall right now as we get ready to celebrate the commencement of our associate degree and certificate earners on Thursday evening. Congratulations again, and I look forward to the rest of the ceremony with you.
This has been, thank you, Dr. Swanson. Appreciate your kind words and your ever-present support. This has been a really interesting semester for us. The students have been challenged in amazing ways that have been good, and some ways that didn't feel so good when they were going through it, but have absolutely strengthened them now that they've come through it. And every semester we put together a little presentation for you just to see the faces of these students so that you can understand exactly who this program is designed to support. I will let the presentation for the semester speak for itself, but I'd like to introduce it by sharing a compiled quote from several students during their Petition to Continue presentation. Before coming to Gateway, I struggled with severe social anxiety. I couldn't go to school, and I was absent so many days. I was worried about how I would talk to people here and fit in. But Gateway was different. The people here embraced me, showed me that they really cared about me, about all of us, and now my anxieties are gone.
I used to bite my tongue and hold my breath, scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I sit quiet. The ground, you helped me.
Don't your babies look really good up there? That's not how they act at home, though, right? I found the best pictures I could find for these young people. Okay. What, Anthony, what? Okay. So while I may serve as the beautiful, say yes, thank you, Ms. Kemmer, yes. Thank you, yes, thank you. The beautiful leader of Gateway, I by no means could make any of this happen without my extraordinary resource specialists. As you saw in the PowerPoint, they are completely dedicated to their students and supporting their goals that this program is truly a success because of them. Lori Davidson and Esau Collins, please lead us in the awards presentation.
Welcome all. I'm Lori Davidson, the resource specialist from the West Campus.
And how everybody's doing today. Today is a good day and it's a great day in our lives and the life of our students. I just want to let you know that we are blessed to be here. I'm Esau Collins, resource specialist for Central Campus. At this time, Ms. Laura Davidson and I want to thank everybody for coming, for taking up your busy schedule to be here. It is important that our students know that they have a great supporter like you. So today, I will ask that our students remain seated while we all stand and give a round of applause for our graduate student. Please stand as you are able. Congratulations, class of 2015.
The GTC staff and foundation faculty have assessed the students' progress during the course of the semester and decided that while most of the students work diligently to meet their academic goals, we want to recognize the outstanding efforts of particular students. With that, we will now begin the awards presentation. I know it'll be hard, but please try to hold all of your applause until the presentations are complete. Student, when your name is called, please come up and Ms. Jezere will give you your certificates. The first award is for perfect attendance. This is awarded to the student who maintained exceptional attendance, was functional, and attended the entirety of every class for the entire semester. For West Campus, this award goes to Jared Kossel. In this program, In this program, we can usually get a sense of how successful a student will be based on their attendance. Jared listened, showed up every day, despite any challenge that he might have faced.
Our second award is the Most Determined Award. Most Determined Award, this is the award to students who continue to demonstrate a steady commitment in their learning regardless of personal, family, and socioeconomic circumstances.
In order for this particular student to graduate this semester, he had to complete our Gateway 5 foundation courses as well as 4 additional online courses through his high school. Some said he couldn't do it, but he said he could. For West Campus, Desmond Faison is awarded the Most Determined Award.
Third award is the most Improved Award. Most Improved Award, this is award to students who has worked diligently to bring up the GPA, attendance, class participation, or attitude as a learner. For Central Campus, this award is awarded to Elena Shield. Elena Shield. She has worked hard in all of her classes this semester. She has improved her learning and study skills. She is a great writer and has the characteristic of a college student.
For West Campus, Jared Kossel is awarded the Most Improved Award. Jared desired a change in his life, his educational setting, and a change in himself as a student. He worked hard this semester to overcome some personal challenges and to also learn that he's really not that bad of a writer.
Fourth award is the Change of Heart Award. I love this one.
Oh, that's me, sorry.
So it's going to be by Lori Davidson.
This is awarded to the student who may have improved academically, who may not have improved academically, but changed their approach to learning and is now in a position to be a successful learner. For West Campus, that student is Nate Cardoza. Nate had many internal conflicts this semester, deciding if school was really for him. In the beginning, I don't believe he was all in, but in the end, he began realizing his true potential, especially as a gifted writer. I think he realized that in order to be successful as a student, he needed to get serious about his future. Congratulations, Nate.
For Central Campbell, this award is awarded to Shaheem Dillon. Shaheem, I can say this. I do believe the saying to improve is to change. To be perfect is to change most often. Shaheem's attendance record has improved and his passion for learning has brought him this far. Shaheem was not interested when he first came into the Gateway to College program, but later he started to focus and completed all his assignments.
The next award is for most courageous. This is awarded to the student who, despite their fears and anxieties about learning or a particular subject, took chances to engage in the learning process. For West Campus, this student is Alexander Yurgis. Alex was our only foundation student this semester to mainstream early and take a traditional college math course. About halfway through the semester, he did come to me to tell me it didn't look good for passing it. With the support of his father, tutors, and a wonderful math professor, Alex pulled off a near perfect on his final exam in order to secure a passing grade for the course. Even though he was confident going into the exam, he still couldn't believe that he passed the course, and I had to actually email the professor to get it in writing for him to believe me.
Sixth award is the Overall Foundation Student Award. Overall Foundation Student Award for the semester is awarded to student who has a strong GPA, attendance record, class participation, positive approach and attitude for learning and participate in all campus activity.
For West Campus, this award goes to Desmond Faison. I can't say enough good things about this young man. Des went above and beyond this semester, not only in his performance academically, but socially. He connected with his professors, he reached out to support many of his peers, and he took advantage of campus opportunities like our lunch and learns, and even took part in our alternative spring break.
For our seventh award is the highest GPA award. It's awarded to the foundation student who achieved the highest grade point average during the first semester as a Gateway to College student.
And once again, this award goes to Desmond Faison. I'm not really sure what else I can add about Desmond, so I will just say some things he once said to me: drive, determination, and grit. Once students successfully complete foundation semester and transition to traditional college-level courses, they are required to perform at a higher academic level and meet the expectations of traditional college students. To acknowledge their efforts, the staff have recognized the following transition students through these awards. The first award we call Perseverance. This is awarded to the transition student who, despite challenging academic courses, decided to maintain enrollment in all of them. This award for West Campus goes to Richard Stover. We call him Seth. Seth had some personal challenges to deal with this semester, and I don't think he thought he even had a chance to complete the semester successfully, regardless of his efforts. Even so, he fought through it. He completed an enormous amount of work in a short period of time, and was successful in a majority of his classes.
And for Central Campus, this award is awarded to Thomas Rosa. He is a very hardworking student. He struggled this semester with his economic course. Thomas has a 43% average after midterm, and he took advantage of the tutorial service every other day. He even sat at my office studying for 2 to 3 hours a day. Well, the good news is Thomas was able to pull his grades up, and at the end of the final semester, he came up with a 73%. Congratulations, Thomas. And Ms. Kam, director of the Gateway to College program, calls this grade the best A of the year. Our ninth award is the Rising Star Award. I love this one. This is awarded to transition students who face adversity in their mainstream college courses but work diligently to achieve academic success. For Central Campus, I have two students, Amanda Golu and Gustavo Asensio. Please. These students already immerse themselves into college life. They have reached out to foundation students during the semester, helping sharing their experience with the program. I believe they will rise up to any challenge academically to achieve their goals. Both of them plan on coming back here at Montgomery County Community College to achieve their associate's degree and transfer to a four-year college. Congratulations. So, transition student of the semester. Transition student of the semester is awarded to transition student who has a strong GPA, attendance record, positive approach, and attitude in learning and participating in campus activity. For Central Campus, again, this is awarded to Thomas Rosa. Thomas is a persistent student. He is determined in whatever he does. He works two jobs. He volunteered to cut up trees after the bad storm. He is a full-time student in Gateway to College program and still finds time to go fishing. Thomas has successfully completed this semester and is on track to graduate next semester.
For the West Campus, Caroline Heasley is awarded the Transition Student of the Semester. Throughout the semester, Caroline showed all the qualities we look for in a successful student, including accountability, responsibility, persistence, good communication, and independence. She's taking it upon herself to complete courses over the summer in order to satisfy her academic requirements earlier than anticipated. She is respected among her peers, and to know her is to love her. Caroline also has the additional honor of serving as the transition student speaker. Caroline, please share a few words of wisdom with the foundation students who are transitioning to the traditional college campus.
Good afternoon. My name is Caroline Heasley, and this semester was my first transition semester in the Gateway to College program. During my foundation semester, which was last semester, the majority of my cohort was placed together for each of our classes. We met with our advisor each week. Teachers were more lenient and forgiving, and overall, the workload wasn't that difficult. However, in each student's transition semester, most of this changes. Students are placed into classes with regular college students. They are not required to meet with their advisor each week. They may have teachers who are very strict, and finally, the workload is far from easy. Although the transition semester is very difficult, it is by no means impossible or catastrophic in nature. My advice for students transitioning for the first time is to try your hardest and that there is absolutely no room for slacking off. Trying your best doesn't necessarily mean that you need to get A's or B's on every test or assignment. A lot of people here who know me probably find this odd coming out of my mouth because I tend to be a perfectionist, but I admit that this has not gotten me anywhere, and it most likely won't get any of you anywhere either. Although I still deal with this perfectionism, I have realized that what matters most is the effort I put into each test or assignment. In my opinion, as long as you try your hardest, you will succeed. Secondly, I advise transitioning students to always ask for help when needed. This semester, whenever I needed help, I would either go to Miss Laurie or to one of my teachers who are always eager to help me. Not asking for help will definitely lead to consequences such as the failure of a grade or a class. Sometimes just an email or a text message to your teacher will make a huge difference in the long run. Finally, I advise you to surround yourself with positive influences. Doing this will make your transition semester more enjoyable and will make you more eager to accomplish your goals. Surrounding yourself with negative energy will do nothing but bring you down. So please, parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, friends, try to be positive influences. Assure them that they can do whatever they set their minds to. If they don't want to get out of the bed in the morning, pull them out of bed and make them go to their classes. When they are feeling like this whole school thing is a waste of time, remind them of their future and of the great results that having an education brings. I would like to finish my speech by thanking a few people who have supported and who have been here for me during my transition semester. This doesn't have to do with transitioning, however, I felt it was necessary. I apologize if this is getting a tad bit long. First, I would like to thank Ms. Lori. Throughout the semester, she always responded to my emails and texts as soon as she could and did all that she could to help me. I also thank her for meeting with me a dozen times to revise my class schedule. Next, I would like to thank Marissa Crabtree for her kindness and positive energy. Whenever I came to school in a somewhat sad mood, her presence would always cheer me up immediately. I also congratulate you on your graduation and wish you the best of luck with your future. I know that you will definitely be successful as a tech vet and that you accomplish great things. I would next like to thank Corinne Russo for being a wonderful friend. I enjoyed your friendship these past few semesters, and I thank you tremendously for your care and support. Thank you also for the times that you came to church with me. I congratulate you on your graduation, and I wish you the best of luck with your future. Finally, because most of my cohort is graduating this semester, I would like to pay a special thanks to all of them. I was terrified of starting the GTC program, but you all made me feel like family. Thank you.
Thank you, sweetheart. That was really good. I know you were nervous to do it, but you did a beautiful job, so thank you. I want you all to just take a little bit of note that there's some students' names who were not called out for the awards, and it's not because they didn't get the award. It was because they weren't present. So the lesson that I need all of you to take from here today is that you need to be present. I'm not going to call your name if you're not present. The world may not call your name if you're not present. So you've got to be there to be counted. So let this be the first and last time that I have to give you this lesson, because I don't want to ever go to a graduation, award ceremony, or anything else that you might be a part of and not see your smiling face there. Okay? Be present. I'm going to ask for Alana and Desmond to come up. So each semester we try, yes, you can come up now. Each semester we try to acknowledge our faculty. I tell my faculty and my students and my staff that I want to give everybody an award because I just think everyone works really, really hard. But sometimes I guess we have to choose. So we're going to have these two students share a little bit about why this particular faculty are getting awards.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Alana Shields, and I have the honor of presenting the faculty awards at Central. This semester, the program would like to recognize Ms. McDonald and Ms. Retro for their hard work and commitment to the students. As our English instructors, these ladies were tough. All the rewrites, grammar checks, and countless essays, but we know that in the end, it was all to help us become stronger, more confident writers. We thank you for being flexible and giving us so many opportunities to work with you to get our assignments done. Ms. McDonald and Ms. Vetro, we thank you for being part of the program and for teaching us this semester.
I am very pleased to be the one to present the faculty award at West to Ms. Halsey. I don't know if she's at, but, oh, there she is. Not only is she a great professor, but she's a great person. It's not every day you find a math professor that helps you with extra work that's not even related to her class. So with her help, I have gotten much, much better at math. Like, it's unbelievable. But, yeah, so I think that the rest of my peers would agree that she's a great teacher. So let's give her a round of applause.
So let's give a round of applause to all of our awards recipients. Dr. Bill Ziegler, principal of Potts Grove High School. Bill has served in education for over 20 years as a teacher, assistant principal, and principal. He is honored to be the National Association of Secondary School Principals Digital Principal of the Year and the president-elect for the Pennsylvania Association of Elementary and Secondary School Principals. Dr. Ziegler is also the host of the Twitter chat for principals, hashtag PAESSPChat. That's hilarious that we talk about Twitter now. I don't have a Twitter account, but apparently it's important. Dr. Ziegler currently serves as a high school principal in a suburb of Philadelphia where he resides with his wife and two teenage children. He served as the president for the PAESSP in 2014, treasurer of the PAESSP, the secondary East Third representative for PAESSP, and the president of the Montgomery County Principals Association. The man has been busy. He has also spoken on Capitol Hill to lobby for better E-rate coverage for schools throughout the nation and continues to speak across the country on the importance of integrating technology into learning. And so I've given you this wonderful bio. But what's important to me is that I emailed Dr. Ziegler, and I think 5 minutes later, I had a response while he was in the airport waiting for a flight to take his students on a trip to Europe. Absolutely, Kemma, no problem. I'll do it. And so here he is today serving as our graduation speaker, Dr. Ziegler.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is an honor to be here and talk to the students and the parents, family members, and the faculty. Faculty, I would like to thank you and the Montgomery County Community College staff for your tireless efforts on pushing our students forward, not just Gateway students, but all of our students here in Montgomery County. I bring greetings from the high school that graduated the first student to enter the Gateway program, Marcus Gordon. I think he was one of the first graduates. And today give it up for Marcus. And today I'm honored that I think we have three Potts Grovians here, Anthony, Braden, and the valedictorian from Potts Grove. Potts Grove's a great place to be, as you can see, right? Little funny story, I had Desmond's father as a teacher when I was teaching. Graduates, I want to tell you a story about a student at Potts Grove, okay? And I'm going to talk to you today, because I want to tell you a story about a student that really struggled academically. This student came from a blue-collar family where both of his parents barely made it through high school and got simply a high school diploma or equivalency. And it was their dream that their son would go off to college and get a degree, a four-year degree, because they didn't have that opportunity. But it was in the ninth grade year that a teacher took that student aside and at a parent-teacher conference said to that student and his parents, "Listen, your son is not college material. He's not going to make it in college." The student got dejected. He got down on himself. And the dad actually said, "You know what? What we're going to do is we're going to move you out of the college prep, and we're going to put you in like a general or a business type of coursework." But the father still had his eyes set on his boy going to college. And so this father goes out, and he actually enrolls his son in Montgomery County Community College. So his son takes the entrance exam, fails the entrance exam to Montgomery County Community College, and before he can get into college to take credits, he actually has to take remedial English and remedial math. Frustrated, tired, and not confident that he could succeed. His father drops him off for the first day at Bluebell campus, and he graduates from Montgomery County Community College with an associate's degree. But it was here, at this college, that student found his passion in life. a passion filled with teaching students and to making a difference in the lives of students in our schools. Student went on to go to Gratz College, where he got a master's degree. Student went on to go to Penn State University, where he got went on to Kutztown, where he got a bachelor's degree. Then he got a master's degree. Then he got a principal's certificate from Penn State University. On a May 19, 2005, I was honored to walk across the stage at graduation at Temple University and be named Dr. William Ziegler. See, I tell you that story because I'm that student. I'm the student that sat in a similar seat that you did, that at one point in your life, you didn't think you could do this. You didn't think that you could persevere. You didn't think that you had the resilience. But guess what? One of you today is going to be a doctor. One of you today is going to be a nurse. You're going to become a businessman or a businesswoman. You're going to own your own company and be an entrepreneur. Here's what I'd like to encourage you to do today. Number one, thank someone that was really important in your life. For me, it was my mother and father. My mother and father believed in me before I believed in me. And without their tireless dedication to my success, I wouldn't be here today. I'd like to thank teachers in my life at Potts Grove High School. I'm a graduate of the school I currently principal at. There are numerous teachers there that invested in my life and spoke into my life. Thank your teachers today. When you're eating over here, take a moment, go over, grab a selfie, tweet it out, and let them know how much you are thankful for that. Here are some key success in life. Number one, keep the relationships close. Let those people just come in close to you. Mom, dad, aunt, uncle, teacher, coach, boss, whatever it might be. Let them help you to get encouraged and inspired, because I'm guaranteeing you this. You are pumped to be here. Can I get a woo-hoo if you're pumped to be here? Yeah, right? But let me tell you something. There will be dark days ahead academically. And that associate's degree may seem much larger than you can accomplish. But as a boy, this is no lie. I remember that bus station out there. I don't know if it's still out there, but there was a little bus depot where you could get off the parking lot. My dad stopped. He drove me to Bluebell, and he actually physically said on the first day, he says, I enrolled you in the classes. Here's your classes. Here's your books. Get out of the car. And I said to him, I'm not getting out of this car. I'm not going to college, Dad. And my dad's bigger than me. So he said, get out of the car. You know what? I'm telling you to get out of the car. Go get that associate's degree. Don't let nothing stop you. Here's the amazing thing. You have a faculty that cares for you. You have family that cares for you. You have friends that care for you. But there will come a time that you're going to have to dig inside of all of you with grit and determination, perseverance and resilience. Don't give up. Succeed. Because I failed the entrance exam, the Monco. Okay? My SAT scores would have been better if I just signed my name and left the paper blank. But listen, I graduated toward the top of my class at Temple University with a doctorate of education. You know what? That comes from perseverance, hard work, building relationships, having people inspire me, and having people come alongside me to kick me in the pants and to pat me on the back. So take this time, bask in what you've accomplished. I am so proud of you, the Gateway students. I got to tell you, I wish all of Montgomery County could come and see this. So I want you to do this tonight. I have three goals for you. Number one, I want you to go thank a faculty member. Thank a Montgomery County Community College employee. Thank them. Second one, I want you to set your goal. What are you going to do? You got it in your mind right now? It was great talking to some of you. You know, hearing one of you going off to the Navy, one's going off to a culinary school, another one's going to go off to business school. Set that goal. Write it down. Put it on your refrigerator. Tweet it out that today you're going to do that. And the third thing is, listen, whoever's your close family member, mom, dad, sister, brother, aunt, uncle, stepmom, stepdad, whoever it is, I want you to give them a hug sometime in the next week, preferably tonight. Thank them for investing in your lives. Students, I want you to know you can do great things. You also can walk across the stage someday and be called doctor. So I want to thank you. I want to thank Montgomery County Community College. And I want to thank everyone for investing in the Gateway program, which is a powerful program that changes lives for a long time and for eternity. So students, congratulations and best wishes to you. Thank you so much. I pray that God blesses you and blesses you all richly as you move to your next levels of education. Thank you.
I have some powerful friends, don't I? Some very powerful friends. Okay. Before we get into the graduation awards or completion certificates, I need to give you a couple awards. Our Gateway Achievers, these are students who received a 2.0 or better this semester. Remember what I said about many names not being called because they're not present. So that makes me a little sad, but I'm going to acknowledge the ones who are here. So just come up and get your awards. Mr. Apold, Gustavo Ascension, Desmond Faison, Amanda Gulo, Carolyn Heasley, Amber Keys, Jamie Kinley, Jessica Lindsay, Cassidy Richards, Mr. Rosa, Saul, Braden Saul, Elena Shields, Seth Stover, Carolyn White, Alex, come on here, Mr. Alex. I have a list, a long list of names. So I'm proud of all of you guys this semester for getting 2.0 or better in your classes. Let's give them a hand. Inside your awards, the Gateway Achiever Awards, you're going to see that there's a letter from the president of the Gateway to College National Network. It's underneath your awards, so cherish that. That's important. It's an acknowledgement of your hard work. My students who are transitioning to mainstream classes, Jessica Lindsay, Jared, Alex, Alana, next semester you guys will be taking mainstream courses. I'm very proud of you. Thank you for letting me know that you're here, Miss Dia. Oh, I love my kids. Okay, so Desmond Faison, our valedictorian. This young man is really special. When Lori did the preliminary evaluation of Des's appropriateness for the program, she was hooked after their first 5 minutes of conversation. He had her at the word integrity. I'm happy to say I am not an old softy mushball like Miss Lori and didn't cave in within the first 5 minutes of meeting him. It took me 6 minutes during our interview to know he was a good fit for the program. He is a man of action and determination, focused and committed. He was so confident that he was going to be valedictorian this semester that he wrote and submitted his speech almost 2 full weeks before the final grades were in, just in case. Well, Desmond, it pays to be confident, determined, and hardworking because with a 4.0 GPA, you are in fact the valedictorian for our spring 2015 GTC graduation. I am happy to have Desmond Faison deliver the speech to the graduating class.
Good afternoon, welcome administrators, professors, fellow students, and most importantly, parents. First, I'd like to start off by giving a special thanks to Mrs. Kemma for all the work she does behind the scenes. I don't think everybody recognizes how much she does, but she goes out and finds fundraisers and sponsors to fund the program, so without that, nobody would be here. So I think we should give her a round of applause. Yeah. Um, Secondly, I would like to say this is an excellent program. And Gateway to College, as high school students, we get the opportunity to taste what college classes are like before we actually graduate high school. This benefits us in many ways, such as giving us a chance to get our diploma and get college credits. We are way ahead of the game. Some of us have realized and some of us haven't yet, but this is a huge kickstart in our lives. To transition students, where y'all at? Raise your hands. Some of you are going to be in this program for another year or two, but you will be far ahead of the kids that are at your high school. All of you are actually ahead of most of the kids that are in your class right now. My advice to you is do not take what you have been given for granted. This program is a privilege, so I would like to remind you that there are probably plenty of other kids at your original high school that would love to be in your position. Some of you haven't been able to connect with people and with clubs here at the college, but some of you have yet make these connections. This semester, I took advantage of Monco's alternative spring break and spent some time with traditional college students and traditional staff. And we were supporting victims of sex trafficking. This is a bigger problem than I think we all realize, because it could be happening in any neighborhood at any time. So I think you should keep your eye out just to see if anything is up, or just look it up on Google, look at the statistics of it, because it's a real important thing to know. The acquaintances that you can make throughout the GTC program can be so beneficial. So please stay open to these opportunities to get involved. And stay on top of your work. It is very easy to fall behind by missing just one class. So keep in mind your grade decreases as your absences increase. So get to class. And as a former alumni once said, early is on time is late, and late is unacceptable. And finally, please do not be scared to ask for help. The faculty is here to help y'all, so don't be scared to ask. They don't know if you need help or if there's something you don't understand if you don't speak up. Now to my fellow graduates, this semester was definitely a roller coaster ride of challenges, but we took hold and embraced our fears and finally made it. So give yourself a round of applause. Although we're all from different districts, we're all able to come together and, as Ms. Kemma says, form a family. There's definitely times when we got on each other's nerves, but I think that was just a way of showing how much we cared about one another's success in the program. I myself will be going to the Navy and attending college for culinary arts while I'm enlisted. So some of us may never see each other again, and some of us might. Some of you will remain here, and you will try to get your associate's degree, and I wish you much success on that. But some of you are just going right into the work field. And I would just like to remind those ones that are just going into the work field that education is viewed very highly in today's society. So you can't really get too many places without it. So though we may never meet again, we'll have all the memories of GTC and how we overcame obstacles and reached our goals. With that being said, class is officially dismissed.
Okay, so Dr. Swanson, this is our favorite part. Please join me in giving our graduates their certificates of completion. I'm so proud of all of you and am honored to celebrate your graduation. So what will happen is you will get your certificate of completion from Dr. Swanson. So you're gonna come up this way and get it from Dr. Swanson, and you're gonna go down and Miss Lori or Mr. Esau will pin you with our special pin for graduates. It's a Phoenix pin, because if we all know the stuff we're coming from, right? We know all of the hard times, the trials, the stuff that almost kept us down. But out of all of those ashes, you all soared. And because of that, you are all my phoenix, my birds, my survivors. And so you will get your pin. Only my babies, yes. Yes, Braden, my babies. Only our GTC graduates have this honor. Okay, I'm gonna try not to cry. I don't know why this is so hard. I think you know why it's hard is because this group, most of you started this program when we started this program. So I think it's just that hard because I'm losing a big chunk of our first 2 years. So I think that's what's got me. Amber Key, start this off for us, baby. Amber thought that we had a little hiccup in her second semester. She had the audacity to tell me she wasn't coming back to school. She thought maybe she was just gonna work. She's not college material. So I said, Esau, if you don't call that child and tell her to come back here. And so she came in, and look at Amber now, graduating with really high grades, a high GPA. Kiara Hayden. I think they call you Smiley, right? Yeah. So Miss Kiara, you know, she experienced some really difficult hardships in the program. In fact, she lost her home in a fire. But she continued and fought through, and look at her today. She is now completed. Mr. Apold. Chris Apold. This young man told me when he sat down in my interview, I'm going into the military. As much as I tried to convince him to be a college student first, he made it really clear, I'm gonna do your program, I'm gonna graduate, and I'm going into the military. And so Chris is going into the military. Good for you, Chris. Anthony Romano. This is my sweetheart right here. What you doing? I don't shake your hand. Thank you. I don't shake your hand. Mr. Romano is one of the students who, no matter when, where, how, if I asked him right now to come with me to a national event to do a presentation about Gateway, his only question is, does he need to wear a suit? And so I am absolutely proud of you for getting to this day. Gustavo Ascension. This is another young man who has surprised me. Because when you started here, you thought you were going into the military. Do you remember that? Yes, you do. Gustavo was staying right here and getting his business marketing degree. So I am so proud of you, Gustavo. Marissa Crabtree. Marissa came to us as shy as she wanted to be. Told me she had all kinds of social anxiety. By the end of the first semester, she said, I think some of my anxiety is gone. By this semester, Miss Butterfly now has a group of friends who surrounds her on a regular basis. And so this young lady is going to be an awesome vet tech one day. Dia, I'm here. Thank you for letting me know you're here. Congratulations, Dia. So Dia is an interesting young lady. I absolutely believe that if she wants to become Dr. Bassett Hester, she can absolutely do it. She has all of the ability, all of the talent, and it's just a matter of time that we'll see it. I told you I don't call out names if you're not here, but I'm gonna call out Tony's name. Tony Jouse is another graduate, but his mother had to go in for surgery, and so he is now home taking care of all of his siblings. I think we should give that young man for his decision to be responsible a round of applause. Gulo. Miss Amanda Gulo. You know, Amanda cracks me up because when she started, I don't know. Y'all laughing because that's how she talks, right? I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know if this school thing is for me. Ms. Gulo has one of the highest GPAs in the program. Congratulations, Ms. Gulo. Ah, Corinne Russo. Congratulations, baby. Corinne is another one of my dear hearts, just nervous and anxious, wanting to always get it right, and had to learn in her during her time in the program that getting it right doesn't mean getting it perfect, it means taking chances. And so Corinne knew how, had to learn how, to take chances, and I'm very proud of you. I'm getting whipped blue for clamped, y'all. John Howell, this man is gonna become president of somebody's country somewhere. He showed up to my orientation and proceeded to give me paperwork as if he was in my program. I said, well, who are you? I'm John Howell. I said, well, I don't remember interviewing you. Oh, there was an interview process? I said, well, John, I don't think you can be in here. John told me to give him a week. Between John and his guidance counselor, we don't know how it happened, but he ended up in his program. In addition to ending up in the program, I believe John Howell has business cards already ready that says president of some country, because he will make sure that that happens. Brayden. Brayden, you had a bit of a little hiccup this semester. But you figured it out. And not only did he figured it out quickly because he was determined to graduate. So I thank you for quickly getting off that plane and getting here from the airport as soon as possible so that we could celebrate you and all of your hard work, Brayden. Mr. Capecchi. James, y'all just tap me on the shoulder. What is, like we in some kind of club. I better give me some love. So James Capecchi, you know, he's one of these quiet people who's just around doing his thing. And we got a little nervous this semester because he was exceptionally quiet. But we found out that he was steadily doing what needed to be done so that he could graduate on time. We appreciate your persistence. Carolyn, where are you, babe? Oh. Miss White, I am very proud of you.
Thank you, Miss Carolyn.
Mm-hmm. So Carolyn told me at her petition to continue, you know, she received some news, and the news could be quite challenging, but she told me, Miss Kemma, don't worry. I am going to make it happen. I am going to graduate with my associates. And that's just how Carolyn has been this entire time that she's been in the program. She's just made it work no matter what news she received. So I expect to go to a graduation for you, Ms. White. All right. Jessica McGinty. This baby of mine. Lord, Lord, Lord. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So Jess worked really, really hard through all kinds of personal adversity. But I tell you, when someone is determined, they are determined. This child got into Marymount College before she was finished here because she was just determined to work, to be on Broadway. And so that is what she wants to do with her life. I believe that that is what you will do with your life, and I need some tickets when you get there. waiting for me at Will Call.
All right.
Cassidy Richards. Congratulations, Miss Richards. You made it happen. Aw, don't you do it. Don't you cry on me. I'm trying to hold my little mascara together. So Cassidy has been dealing with a lot of personal challenges this semester, and we weren't quite sure if she was going to make it. But no matter how much she had to deal with, Cassidy still ended up with one of the highest GPAs in the program. And it's simply because she can do the work. So if we can get past all of life, Cassidy, you can take on this world. Good job. Liam, Mr. O'Neill, where are you? You remember when this boy came in just as shy as he wanted to be, and you were a little nervous too. I had to sit with both of y'all and talk to y'all. Look at your son now. Look at what he's done. So Liam wasn't quite sure about this whole college thing because high school wasn't really working too well anyway. But he came in here and he put his nose to the grindstone and he made it work. Every single morning he found himself at Mr. Esau's desk to do whatever work needed to be done to make it happen. Oh, whew, okay, I'm not gonna cry. You know, there's some students where you know they have a lot of potential, but they haven't quite figured it out yet. So Liam's one of those students who had not quite figured it out. Now remember, we were sitting in my office and I told you he'll figure it out, and he figured it out. You have a high school graduate with college credits now, Mr. O'Neill. He figured it out. You're welcome, honey. Desmond, come on up here, honey. So I told y'all that Miss Lori knew within 5 minutes. This young man came to his initial interview an hour late. I said, now, I don't know how much love you got for this child, but he's an hour late. I got to get home to Sebelius. Y'all know I got to go meet that van when he comes home from school. But he came in and she said, Miss Kim, I promise, just please. Literally within 1 minute, I knew. Not only did he maintain accountability for being late, he went to the wrong campus, figured out what was going on, and made his way to where he was supposed to be. And he told us, you know, Miss Lori, you probably did tell me what time and where to be, so I'm gonna, you know, maintain responsibility for that. I think I need to pay more attention. That's when he had me hooked. This man came in, if you look in Lori's classroom, I think you have like plastered her entire wall with all of your grades because you were determined to be valedictorian. I appreciate your determination because it was infectious. You spread it in that room. Nate Cardozo. Mr. Nate is one of those people who doesn't know how much potential he really has. So he's still searching. He's still searching. And while he's searching, I just kept fussing. And Miss Lori kept fussing. And his teachers kept fussing. And he eventually made his way through his first semester here with us. I am absolutely confident, Nate, once you figure out your it will be phenomenal. So keep figuring it out. Good job, Nate. Our last graduate for the evening, Miss Jamie Kinley. Jamie just came in and steadily did what she was supposed to do. But you know, you're welcome, baby. One of the things that I want to make sure that I say to you, Jamie, even though you had one semester with us and you worked diligently as best you could, no matter what is going on in your life, no matter how tough it gets in your world, you control your destiny. So make your word be your law. Do whatever it is that you need to get done despite all that you need to deal with, and it will happen. I promise you. Amber, Kiera, Christopher, Anthony, Gustavo, Marissa, Dia, Amanda, Corinne, John, Braden, James, Carolyn, Jessica, Cassidy, Liam, Desmond, Nate, Jamie. You have all received your certificates of completion, your official Montgomery County Community College transcript, and your special GTC pin. Am I correct? Yes? So then I now declare you high school graduates completed with the Gateway to College program, and I offer you all my congratulations and my love. I did it, y'all. I did it. Not one tear dropped. But I told it to go back in, so it went back in. As soon as I get off stage. So I want to thank all of you again for coming out and showing your support. It is my absolute pleasure to serve you and your students. But now to business. Transition students, I will see you all here on June 10th. At noon for the start of your mandatory, I didn't say questionable, your mandatory, I didn't say if you like it, your mandatory summer academic achievement enrichment program. Don't forget to go get the second book in the Giver series, Gathering Blue, from your local library, or buy it if you want a copy. Parents, Jezeray will send you a copy of the summer syllabus and assignments. Please make sure that your babies are here on time. That's June 10th at noon, Science Center, 214 South Hall, 221. And thank you all for coming.
Wow, I have the challenge of closing remarks after all that. I don't know how much more can be said. But I do think it's important that those of you who just graduated take a moment to thank your vision supporters. Dr. Ziegler, encourage you to give those who have supported you a hug this evening or sometime in the next week. Let's do something publicly. Please stand, turn around, and applaud your vision supporters who are here for you today. I learned a lot from you. I learned a lot from this program and listening in throughout the afternoon. A couple of closing thoughts. Education is about finding purpose and discovering there's a world that's greater and bigger than ourselves. As we discover that world, we, to use some of the words from the slideshow, I saw, my voice really does matter. Your voice really does matter. And the more educated you become, the more that voice will be heard and understood as you share it with the rest of the world. I think that's really important. Education is about finding purpose. Many of you have done that through this program. I saw your goals. You're going to go on into the military, or you're going to major in business or culinary or human services or computer science. Some of you are still discovering your purpose, and I hope your continuing education will allow you to do that. I heard from Caroline, you made me feel like family. Montgomery County Community College is a wonderful family. Dr. Ziegler is a part of that family, is one of our alums. You will, as you continue with us, continue to be part of our family and will continue to be even after you leave as one of our alums. Please consider us your family and we'll consider you ours. Gateway to College really does change lives. It changes the lives of the students who are in it, but I think it's important that all the students in the program know that it changes our lives too. Those of you who are administrators, faculty, and staff supporting the program, you've changed our lives by your presence here at Montgomery County Community College. Your drive, your determination, grit, and perseverance, to use some of the words I heard this evening, make a difference in my life. And this is why I get up and come to work every day, because I see the things that face you, your challenges, the barriers, and you keep coming every day anyway. I don't know if I was your age, if I had that same level of grit, if I had that same level of determination and perseverance. I can't guarantee that I would have overcome those same barriers. You inspire me. You inspire those of us who work at this college every day. I know you inspire the high school staff that are here to support you as well. So thank you. Thank you for being part of changing our lives as well. With that, congratulations. Let's enjoy the reception.